Hey guys, it's Carrie. I'm looking at spiders, insects, and centipedes today. Tarantulas are the largest extant spiders. They have large hairy bodies and legs. Their bite can be painful, although a tarantula's venom has low toxicity for us. Tarantulas grow by shedding their old exoskeleton and growing a new one. This molting process can take a few hours and will happen several times until the tarantula reaches full size. Tarantulas move slowly on their eight hairy legs, but they are accomplished nocturnal predators. Insects are their main prey, but they also target bigger game, including frogs, toads, and mice. Tarantulas are burrowers and typically live in the ground. These spiders grab prey with their legs, injecting paralyzing venom, and then bite their prey with their fangs. They also secrete digestive enzymes to liquefy their victims' bodies so that they can suck them up through their straw-like mouth openings. Tarantulas have eight eyes, but they still rely heavily on other senses and are very sensitive to sounds and vibrations. These eyes have different jobs, with the two largest eyes designed to detect size. They have four smaller eyes underneath these two, which are used to help determine distance. A tarantula also has an eye on each side of its head, as it cannot turn round so easily to see. Please subscribe and turn on notifications. Wolf spider. Unlike other arachnids, which are generally blind or have poor vision, wolf spiders have excellent eyesight. They catch their prey by running fast. The Sydney funnelweb spider is considered the most venomous spider in the world, although there is an anti-venom available. They can survive immersion in water for several hours and can deliver a bite when removed from the water. Their fangs are large and powerful, capable of penetrating fingernails and soft shoes. The Australian funnelweb spiders make their burrows in moist, cool, sheltered habitats, usually under rocks or rotting logs. Huntsman spider. They are sprinters and gymnasts, able to execute incredible leaps and tumbles to catch prey and escape from predators. These spiders prefer damp, sheltered woodland, and it's often found on the lower branches of oak saplings, on tall grass or sedge tussocks, where it sits head down, waiting to pounce on passing insects. Black widow spider. It is prey for birds and other spiders. Although poisonous, the black widow is not considered aggressive unless threatened. Redback spider. It is a venomous spider that lives in Australia. The female is larger than the male. The female's body is about 1 centimeter long, and the male's body is about 3 millimeters long. The adult female spider is usually black and has a red stripe on its back. I can always tell a redback's web because it's very messy and untidy. velvet spider. They have a smooth, velvety appearance. They generally have a broad profile and are found under rocks or bark, resting in a sheet of dense white silk. Scorpion. They are arachnids and have 8 legs like their cousins, the spiders. They look a bit like small lobsters. Equipped with a pair of pincers and a thin segmented tail that curves over their back. They are most common in desert areas. When hunting, a hungry scorpion will quickly grab its prey with its pincers and then whip its telson, the poisonous tip of their tail, forward to sting and kill the doomed victim. Scorpions use their tail to defend themselves against predators such as snakes, lizards, and birds. They have super survival skills. They can withstand incredibly harsh climates, both hot and cold. In the desert, they burrow underground to keep cool. Praying mantis. These insects get their name because they have very long front legs that they hold in a position that reminds people of praying. They are the only insects in the world that can turn their heads 180 degrees. This superpower is useful when hunting prey. Praying mantises silently sit and wait for prey to approach. Being able to turn their head and see around them helps them find prey without moving and giving away their location. Grasshopper. They are leaping insects that are found all over the world. They are closely related to crickets. They have amazing jumping skills. They can jump around 25 centimeters high and around 1 meter long. Relative to size, that would be like us jumping the length of a football field. Stag beetle are spectacular. The male's large jaws look just like the antlers of a stag. They are actually oversized mandibles used in courtship displays and to wrestle other male beetles. Males are often seen flying around at dusk searching for a mate. They will wrestle or fight other males using their enlarged antler-like jaws. Rhino beetle are said to be the strongest animals on the planet. They can lift up to 30 times their own weight. Some species even more. Centipede, they have long segmented bodies covered in a tough, flexible exoskeleton. Each segment has one pair of legs and there is a pair of antennae on their heads. At the head, one pair of legs is modified to work as fangs that bite and deliver venom. Ladybug, sometimes known as lady beetles or ladybird beetles. They are beneficial as they eat other plant-eating insects. They are colourful, so warn predators not to eat them. And they are beetles, not bugs. One ladybug can eat up to 5,000 insects in its lifetime. I've seen them on my roses eating the aphids. Dragonfly. With reproduction, while in flight, the male approaches the female from behind, grabs hold of her thorax with his legs, and sometimes bites her in an effort to quickly subdue her. Pulling his abdomen forward, he uses his anal appendages to hold her by the neck while continuing to fly with her in a formation referred to as a tandem linkage. The male dragonfly prepares for sex by transferring his sperm to his penis. The male links his penis to the female's genital opening, which is located near her neck. Once their sex organs are linked, the dragonfly couple forms a closed circle with their bodies. Honeybee, they can only sting once because their barbed stinger tears off when they try to get away, killing them. Bumblebee, they harvest nectar and pollen from flowering plants. They live in smaller groups than honeybees and do not tend to swarm. Bumblebees hibernate underground. Mosquito, they can drink up to 3 times their weight in blood. Caterpillar, they are insects just like their parent butterflies or moths. They have 6 proper legs like all insects, but also up to 5 pairs of stumpy prolegs with little hooks that help them to hang on to things and to move in a wave-like motion. Caterpillars use small hooks on their feet to climb plants. A caterpillar is a kind of larva. When it's older, the caterpillar will turn into a pupa, also known as a chrysalis, and then later the pupa will turn into a butterfly. A butterfly, or moth, is what emerges from the chrysalis. It will wait a few hours for its wings to fill with blood and dry up before flying for the first time. Butterflies have 4 wings. They often have brightly colored wings with unique patterns made up of tiny scales. Butterflies feed on nectar from flowers, and they have taste receptors on their feet. Monarch butterfly are large, beautifully colored butterflies. They're easily recognized by their striking orange, black, and white markings. Its bright colors tell predators, "Don't eat me, I'm poisonous." The butterflies get their toxins from a plant called milkweed, which is their only food source in the caterpillar stage. An animal that eats a monarch butterfly usually doesn't die, but it feels sick enough to avoid monarchs in the future. Tortoiseshell butterfly? They hibernate in their adult form, often in houses and sheds, and then emerge again in spring to feed on nectar and lay large amounts of green eggs on the underside of nettle leaves. This stick insect is wingless and nocturnal, feeding only on 1 species of shrub. They are critically endangered. Giant Weta is found in New Zealand. At their largest, they can have bodies up to 10 centimetres in length and a leg span as wide as 20 centimetres. Rose Chafer Beetle, they feed primarily on flower blossoms, especially roses and peonies, causing large holes. They also damage many trees and shrubs and other plants. Honeypot ant are sterile worker ants which are used as food stores. They develop swirled abdomens filled with food by other worker ants. They are living storage containers. You'll find some interesting information on arachnids and insects in the description. Please stay and watch another video with me. I love to read and reply to all of your comments. Thank you for watching my video. See you again soon. See you guys in my next video.